website with Inkscape just to test the power of this software and see its capabilities. And also I wanted to have a clean, nice looking website using the new magazine style, what Microsoft Windows start calling Metro style, but now it's called magazine, probably because the fans for Mac users. But this is a style, clean, easy to navigate and all of that. And as you see, there's a many elements that I'm using to create a web. And this is gonna be the hover. When you hover over a link or something like that, the pointer will look like this. All the section, how the articles from my blog will display. And this is a test that I have on my local host of using this technique. As you see, it changes a little bit. While I was developing, I come up with different ideas. But see how the icon of the mouse changes when I hover, and exactly the design that you saw there, the element that I create for that. And this is a simple HTML website using PHP in the background for the Ajax, creating the HTML5 website. This is a static HTML. Here is gonna be my portfolio, images, slideshow of my portfolio, and obviously services, and the standard navigation is gonna be a simple navigation. And all this was designed in the amazing Inkscape. And I'm gonna show you how to do that. Well, I have a project that I'm working on, and I'm gonna use it as an example to create our website. First of all, when you're designing a website right now, one of the features of the website that I'm gonna be designing, it has to be a simple image with simple navigation buttons, like 5 buttons, and it's gonna have a big image on the background, and the navigation buttons will be 5 navigation buttons, and that's it. That's gonna be the website. So I'm gonna design it here. That way you have too many advantages to design something before you put it on the web. First, it's gonna be easier for you to determine what you're gonna do for your CSS, how you're gonna manage your CSS. And I'm gonna start with the default. Here's the window. So the default is gonna give us this A4 paper size. I guess the developers for Inkscape are from Europe. And the Europe area, haven't checked it out, but they're making an amazing work. Well, I'm gonna change this, and to change the artboard, the only thing that you need to do is go to File, and you see in the menu something that's called Document Properties. And Document Properties, I can change the aspect. I'm gonna be using pixels for now. So I'm gonna make a standard HD web HD size, 1280 by 720 pixels website. So I'm gonna try to accommodate the image, because this is almost most of the screens today uses these aspect ratios, is what we see. If you don't understand, what we see around said 16 by 9. This is the 16 by 9 ratio. So that's when you design your website, just try to use this aspect ratio, either portrait or landscape, depending what you're designing for, because our customers are more guided to desktop. I will not bother to make this for a mobile, but if you're gonna make a mobile website, I will suggest to start with the portrait and start with the minimum screen size, and after that you spread it out so you make a responsive website. But for now, we're gonna make something simple. First, the customer wants to have a photo in the background, and I'm gonna use any photo from, for this example, I'm gonna use a photo from the stocks that I download from Stock Exchange, an amazing website, Stock Exchange. You can find it here. I have a lot of stuff open. Let me close. This is another customer website, and my website, so Instagram. I don't want Facebook to pop up now, so let's call and cancel it. Now, to access Stock Exchange, the address is sxc.hu. This is an amazing free image stocks. And it was bought by, forgot the name. It's a very popular. They have a paid version that is called iStockPhoto. And they were bought by a big company, Getty Image. But you're gonna get nice photos in this site, and most of them you don't have to give any credit, which I just suggest to give credit. Those people work hard and waste a lot of money on photography, so I suggest to give credit to whoever whoever credit is owner. So now I'm gonna use any image. Let's use that one, and I'm gonna link it. So as you see, this is a big image, but I'm gonna accommodate it to that. All right, so now that I have this, this is awesome. You see that you cannot see the artboard, and don't worry about it. The only thing that you need to do is position it there. Go back to File, Document Properties, and say Border on Top of Drawing, and that will show the artboard border in top of the design. Those of you that are used to Illustrator around that, they always put the artboard in top. Obviously something I think it should be put on the default. And you don't have to worry, the image goes off if you're kind of green like me. What you can do is just create another NetBeans, fabulous IDE. Create a block CSS for the layout. To make this, convert that into an HTML, then we're gonna use the power of NetBeans. Oops. PostScript. Okay. Obviously, the problem is that NetBeans. Trying to copy the SVGs file. So, quit. And I want to do this. Save on tutorial. Simple layout SVG and save. All right, so we close that. We have our simple layout there. Yes. If you're saving, this is something that you had to deal with. If you have Inkscape open, Inkscape save everything in the SVG format. If you have any folder linked to NetBeans, NetBeans is trying to read that and create a conflict between these two, Inkscape and NetBeans. Other than that, just keep in mind not to do it. Now, we have all this. Now I'm gonna copy my let's open this baby again. And with Inkscape, because we keep we made that image on the standard 16x9, and it's beautiful. Look beautiful. Now let's add another option that is called math. Now we got can add more space in between the buttons. We had to add the body area, but let's just do the body. So I don't leave you hanging. Inkscape. That's an amazing software. I suggest you to start working with it. If you're not a professional designer, it's free. If you're a professional designer, it will make your life easier, even easier than Photoshop and all that. I hope you have enjoyed this. Happy designing and happy coding. Goodbye.